Well, it is easier than ever to spend money with Tap and Go, as well as being able to pay with your phone.
Yeah, but apparently it's not easy enough. Almost one in three people are in support of having a microchip debit card implanted under their skin. Let's go head-to-head on this with Nine Honey, Shelley Horton and WSFM's Brendan Josie Jones. Shelley is already nodding to the chip. You would chip yourself in a heartbeat.
I would so chip myself. So, this happened to me the other day. I had my credit card out and I was walking the dogs and I stopped at the butcher's to buy some steaks, got home with the leads, everything, and could not find my credit card anywhere. So I had to go back outside, retrace my steps, couldn't find it. Turns out I'd actually put it between the two steaks in the freezer.
How'd it taste?
My credit card was in the freezer. What are the chances?
Well, that's one way to stop spending money.
No, but I'm like, if I had my wrist chip, I could have just gone, yoink, done.
Where can you put it? Like, where do you put this
Where do you
chip?
Want to put
it's
it?
On your,
where,
you know. They're saying in between the fingers where there's less nerve endings, apparently.
Right, so
in here.
Yeah, I think.
So, but then you have to do like a nano-nano.
You have to do like gang signs, and all of a sudden you started some sort of thing. I think that's cool. You know, it gives a new meaning to tap and go, though, doesn't it? Like, really.
What
depending
for
on
blokes.
Where you put it, I suppose.
How would your teenage children spend your money, Jonesy?
Exactly.
You know,
they're just spending it now. I saw one of them going through my will the other day.
No, he didn't.
The
what,
girl
really?
Going through my will, and next to it is like how to tamper with a motorcycle. I'm thinking, you know.
Wow.
Wow. I might be a bit paranoid, but.
But would you get the chip?
Yeah, I would. I'm a
just the chip?
What do you mean?
You can just get a little chip there or a chip here, no problem. Just one chip or two chips?
Well, see, look at this. I've got extra skin between here. Look at this.
Look, you're webbed.
What are you, the man from Atlantis? Webbed.
Yeah.
You're webbed.
I'm like Jason Momoa.
You're an amphibian.
So anyway, look at that extra skin.
That is chip-worthy. That's just hanging.
Would it make you spend irresponsibly?
No, because you've got tap and go now. You boom, boom, we're done.
Why'd you get that skin snipped?
Why did you get that snipped?
Okay.
I know a good doctor.
Well, before we go too much off on that topic, let's talk about a completely different one. A national inquiry has found that more and more children are falling asleep in classrooms and struggling with their schoolwork because of their electronic devices.
Yeah, this is according to a parliamentary inquiry. Up to 24% of all children now have frequent problems sleeping. 70% of teens are estimated to have insufficient sleep. Jonesy, you've got a young fella still in high school. And we also know now that kids need more sleep in high school. So if they're using their screen time for what little sleep they're losing, this is terrible for them.
I went into my son's room and it's always just, you know, a 16-year-old when you just open the door and see what they're doing.
Smell.
So he's got, it's like he's got an SP booking agency there. He's got one screen, two screens, his phone and a TV all going at once.
Wow.
And he's got headphones on. He's having conversations.
Is he hacking into mainframes?
I don't know what he's doing. But you know what he's doing?
Is it war games?
He's changing that will.
So I've grabbed his thing. I've grabbed his laptop. What are you watching? He's watching an ad for Flex Tape. Have you seen Flex Tape?
No.
A guy cuts a boat in half and then sticks it back together with his incredible sticky tape.
Wait, are you supposed to buy Flex Tape?
No, I'm not. I'm just saying, because it's hopeless. It doesn't work. So there you go. Because I bought a roll. But anyway... I cut the boat in half and it's sunk. But my point is, he's watching. I don't even know what to do.
How do you sleep in that room with all those screens?
But then on the other screen, he goes, oh, Dad, I'm doing my, because he's doing his HSC at the moment. He says, and he's doing advanced English. He said, I'm doing my English assignment here. And I went, well, how would I know? And I said, that's not a phase of studying. That's a phase of enjoyment. So
English is enjoyable.
Yes.
I loved English in high school.
Get into English, mate.
You
read a book.
You were such a cool kid, weren't you, Jane? You were so
cool.
Shelley, I mean, it's the lights, though. You know, what I like about Twitter is you can have that black background so I can do Twitter at night and not lose my sleep.
Get no blue screen again. Yeah. I actually think back to my teenage years and the sleep-ins and the sleeping was the best bit. And I can't imagine not wanting to have those sleep-ins. I think sleep-ins are wasted on kids and you know, teenagers because really... It's one of those incredible things as an adult. You're like, naps are delicious. But I can totally understand because I get wired looking at my screens before I go to bed. Yeah. I have to ban myself and go back to this old-fashioned thing called a book.
Yeah.
Like, I can't even do Kindle. I can't do that.
Because you're not supposed to get on a device as you're going to sleep because it wires you up. So, yeah, I just start reading.
But have you tried reading nowadays? I start reading
a book and I'm like,
I'm like maybe a paragraph of my...
it's actually great. It's like better than any sleeping tablet.
Thank you to all the novelists out there. Just quickly, a bridesmaid has sparked debate online about asking whether she is out of line in expecting a plus one for her partner to attend the wedding she's a part of. Mm. So what do you think about this? Because it may not be a full commitment. You know, you don't know if that partner's going to last if you're hosting the wedding and spending that money.
Look, weddings are so expensive, and as far as I'm concerned, it is up to the bride and groom to set their own rules. There are no wedding etiquette, you know, decisions these days. And exactly that, if this is a partner that maybe the bride doesn't like, or it's a partner that was on again, off again, that's, you know, you're talking about a lot of money for one person sitting at that table.
When you're the bridesmaid there, you're up in the upper echelons, and she'd been going out with that guy for a year. I don't think
she's but also the bridesmaids are working the whole wedding, so they don't even really spend that much time with their partners. Have a night off.
But who's going to eat the chicken or the fish? Who's going to get the man meal or the girl meal?
Oh, one's a man meal. There's time.
Ain't nobody got time for that. I would
let you live
with
time.
Just go to Jonesy on his Twitter at night time.
Brendan Jonesy Jones, come on. I'll go live.
Thanks, guys.
From teddies to socks, coming up the long list of presents.